Actually, I'm new to this school. Is this the classroom I'm supposed to be in?
No, but somewhere over the rainbow is Loserland, and that's where you belong.
Yeah, over there is where major losers like you belong.
Can't you read? It says detention, not little La La Land. This room is for the cool kids. Out there, it's for the stupid kids just like you. So, bye-bye.
I didn't even study. I wasted all my time playing video games.
I really hope there's a substitute teacher.
Agreed.
What the heck is that thing?
That's weird. How did I get here?
Yeah, 1 second I was in my bed and now I'm at school.
Look guys, it's in the canteen too. It's not just us.
What is going on?
Not sure, but we should find a teacher.
There are no teachers. We checked before we got here.
No teachers?
Stop. We already tried that.
No answer.
I'm worried. What if something else bad happens?
They'll be okay. I mean, that's why we're sleeping here at school.
Yeah, we can all be together and we know it's safe.
Yeah.
Guys, we can't fall asleep.
Fell asleep. Natalie's gone.
No, she's back. Our parents.
Yeah.
Let them go and unbrainwash them.
No, because you'll destroy me.
Do all that, and we promise we won't destroy you.
If you promise.
It's my mom. They're safe.
What happened to us?
I don't know.
I think we were brainwashed.
Get them.
Deal.
If you thought that, you were really brainwashed.
Did you see Ariel's hair? I mean, blonde was not a good choice on her.
Well, I'm not one to judge, but blonde is not good on her.
Yeah, well, did you hear about the new Disney princess?
What? I went to the library to find her book, and there weren't any, just movies. Well, when I found out that she was a movie character, I just think it's kind of weird because she's not animated like the rest of us. But I'm not one to judge based off of appearance.
I know, and she's always shooting bad guys, and she doesn't even wear a dress. Hardly princess material at all. Yeah!
Well, imagine little girls looking up to and dressing like her. I mean, did you see what she wore to Jabba the Hutt's palace?
The worst thing about Princess Leia is that she doesn't have a dress. Or a color. Besides white. Exactly, and that big hairy guy she's always hanging around with, what's it, Cookie? Wookie?
Hey! It's not that bad. It's what's underneath all that hair that counts.
Yeah!
Anyway, she is technically a princess.
Well, technically she's a princess, but if she can't sing like a princess, drink tea like a princess, or talk to animals like a princess, she ain't a princess. Yeah, it was more like I didn't really understand what was happening at the time. Yeah? No? Lessers! She does not have a prince, a book, or a fairy godmother, so we wanted to hear what you have to say.
So we would like to hear from all of you. What do you think? Should we allow Princess Leia into the Princess Club?
Honestly, I vote no. She doesn't even have, like, a kingdom or a planet. We'd have to make her, like, a whole new world. Too much drama.
Me either. Have you seen those hairstyles? So long ago. Hashtag space buns, ew. That's a good one. I should tweet it. Oh my god. You're so gross. It looks so bad on her. It's just like cinnamon rolls on each side of her head. Like, that's not hair, that's my breakfast.
Seriously, guys, I think we should help her out.
Ugh, that was so annoying. She just goes on forever, and, like, she's not even a princess. She's a nymph? Or, like, boring.
Because she's an actual Disney princess, and she doesn't have a home, so I think that we should care about her.
Okay, we get it, Meg. Soon you're gonna have us all acting like her. Just let it go, everyone.
Look, I'm not sure. She carries around, like, some kind of blaster rifle, and have you heard about her family? It's, like, so messed up.
I mean, her first kiss was her brother. It wasn't even her true love. Not princess material.
I think she'd be a real fish out of water here.
Exactly. I've heard the wolf cry to the blue corn moon, but I ain't never heard of no Millennium Falcon.
It's a spaceship.
Hey, guys! I met this friend. She said she's a princess. And look, she even knows how to build a snowman.
It's actually a droid.
Oh, I have a bad feeling about this.
Yeah, I didn't really, like, understand what was happening. I mean, we were all, like, fighting, and then, like, I kind of smiled at her, try to move the conversation along. Yeah.
They're all so stupid. Like, just, I don't even know why I'm in the club. They're just so stupid.
I mean, like, I can be part of the club, I don't have to be part of the club, it really doesn't matter to me. Like, I don't really know why I'm here right now.
Hey, do you mind if I tag along with you? I'm not really a princess, I'm more of a goddess.
Fine by me.
Where are we going?
A galaxy far, far away.
Yeah, I'd consider myself a princess. If you just called me Leia, it wouldn't really stand out as much, but if you say Princess Leia, you know exactly who you're talking about. Rapunzel kept making the same point that she was so old, and she is so old. She's, like, born in the 70s old. I heard she freed, like, an entire planet of teddy bears. How cool is that? I love teddy bears!
Can you wake up? We're trying to do an interview.
What?
Thank you.
there. I'm very excited to announce our sixth season. We will be back next summer, same week, the 10th and 17th, here at Evanston Township High School. So I'm so excited to be back. We also have our pre-college program, which I am over the moon about, that we started 2 years ago with our partner here in Illinois, Roosevelt University Chicago College of Performing Arts. Education has always been my forefront, especially arts education. And last year, directly from our pre-college Roosevelt program, we had 12 students accepted into the BFA program directly from the summer intensive. So that's huge. We're so excited. Okay. I'm also excited to announce from that end of the spectrum that next year we are launching BB Tots for 5 to 7 year olds, which will be part of next week. Come on, a 5 year old walking the red carpet, is there anything cuter than that? So we will start that next summer, and that will be available to you. If you register for next summer by Monday, you will save $250 off of registration. That ends on midnight on this coming Monday as your pre-registration for returning students. So, I say this all the time, my mom's actually just flew into town texting me like, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm busy, I've got children. But I say that to thank all of you parents. I was so fortunate to have a great arts education, and I thank you all so much for understanding what the importance of having an arts education. So please give your parents a hand.
Thank you.
guys ready?
Yeah!
Are you sure?
Yeah!
Because I think he's here. So I think we're just going to start with some questions from me first, and then we'll move on to their questions. Don't let the paparazzi freak you out.
I love paparazzi.
I know, right?
Hey, guys.
So I think what everyone's dying to know is, how did you get into theater?
Take a picture.
Oh my goodness, how did I get into theater? I actually didn't get into theater until I was in like high school or middle school. And I just did the middle school musical, and I just did it for fun for like 3 years, and then I did the high school musicals for fun, and then I decided that I wanted to do it as a career, so I went to college, and that's when I started dancing. So I actually didn't start dancing until college and doing all of that, taking it seriously until I was in college. So you guys are already a step ahead of what I did. So.
Where did you go to college?
I went to Wichita State. That's in Kansas. Does everybody know where Kansas is?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's in the middle, right dab in the middle of Kansas.
And what was that audition process like to get into college?
To get into college, my audition process wasn't very difficult because they accepted everybody. But now, when you audition for college, you have to sing two songs, sometimes three, and then you have to do a monologue. And then it's all about your personality as well. So you have to show some kind of personality because a lot of these schools are all about if you're going to fit in with everybody else that they've brought in. So that's really important to a lot of schools, especially the big ones.
Do you guys know what show Daxton is in right now?
Do you know what show I'm in?
Yes.
Mormon?
I'm sure a lot of you haven't seen it because you're a little young.
A few of them actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, we got one tonight too. Is it the first time you've seen it?
No, it'll be the second.
Oh, okay, got it. So I play one of the lead roles in the Book of Mormon. I tap dance. I have a tap dance number as my claim to fame for my character. It has bad words in it, so probably a lot of you haven't seen it, but it's up there with popularity, like with the Wiccans and the Phantoms and the Hamiltons.
So what was that audition process like?
That audition process took 6 weeks. Every week I went in and did something different for them. So every time you go in, you have a new piece of music to learn, or you have new sides to learn, or you have a new dance to learn. And then the final audition I had, they actually vocalized me to make sure I could sing the score because it's really high. And so that was just me and the associate music director and the casting team. And we just sat in there and we sang, and then a week later, I got the phone call that I was going to join the Broadway cast. So that's how the audition process works. For Book of Mormon, it did. Anyway, they're all different. I know some people that have had two auditions and then they're on Broadway. So, and then there's some people that audition for shows, like people on the Broadway cast auditioned for like 3 years and then they finally booked the Broadway show. So it just depends on what they're looking for and who they're looking for.
So before we open it up to their questions, my personal question for you is, if you had one piece of advice to give to someone just starting their professional career or even right before they got into it, what would that be?
Be nice.
Be nice.
Genuinely nice and always listen. Be nice, be nice, be nice, be nice. I can't say it enough. And I think it'll take you above anything more than talented people. It'll always put you a step ahead.
Cool. Are you guys ready to ask some questions? Raise your hand if you have a question. Yes, what's your question?
Hi, my name is Tori. I'm 7th grade, I'm 16. What is your favorite song in the Book of Mormon?
In the Book of Mormon? Well, I'm biased, so I like Turn It Off. And if it's one I don't, that's the song I sing in the show, if you haven't seen it. And if it's not something that I sing, I really like Baptize Me. If you've seen the show, it's a really funny spin-off on kind of some bad behavior.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Sasha. I'm 10 years old. And when did you, like, figure out that I
want to
do this, like, as my wife?
Probably in college, my freshman year of college. I was going to be a double major. I was going to do elementary education. I was going to be a teacher. But I decided to I thought I could take it seriously. I went to New York, I visited New York. I did one audition there just to like see what it was like. And I was like, you know what, I think I could do this, or I at least need to give it a shot. So I gave it a shot, and I'm still currently working, I'm still doing it. And so I think as long as I'm doing it and I'm happy, I think that's when I'll keep thinking I can do it, doing it as a real life job.
What was the show that you auditioned for in New York?
Spamalot.
Okay.
And I got a call back, but then I went into the dancing room and I was not very good at it. So it was, it's funny because the man who choreographed Book of Mormon also choreographed Spamalot. So it's funny now that I'm doing his show like 10 years later almost.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yes, Reese.
I'm Reese, I'm 11 years old. And why did you choose Book of Mormon to audition?
Why? I don't really. There's no choice. I just knew I was right for it. Mormons are very all-American looking, because it's an all-American religion, and so I look like the type. So I think it's very important to know what kind of roles you can play, and then to go for those. So I just knew I could do it, and so that's why I auditioned for it.
Yes,
My name is Caitlin, I'm 9 years old, and I just wanted to ask, how many plays have you been in?
I've been in a lot. I did a lot of stuff in college. Probably 10, 15 big professional ones. And then Book of Mormon I've been doing for a long time. I was in the Broadway show for 2 years, and then I've been on tour for almost 2 years. But I've been kind of doing a lot of different things. I didn't just play this role. So it's been a while with the show, but it's fun to do, so I keep doing it.
Hi, I'm Janie, I'm 16. I'm just wondering what your favorite role is that you've ever played.
Bud Frump in How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying. Very fun. Very similar to what my McKinley is, so when you see the show tonight.
I'm Grace Maliband, I'm 11 years old, and I was wondering, did you get the part you wanted in this current show that you're doing?
It's funny, because I actually was a swing, and a swing for everybody is somebody who covers or is an understudy for just the ensemble. So when you get Broadway, you're just kind of like, yay, I got Broadway, and it's my Broadway debut, and I'm like so excited. So I got what I wanted in terms of I wanted to be on Broadway. Then I started seeing the characters and been like, oh, I can do that. So I auditioned for the understudy for McKinley. I was just like, look, I want to understudy McKinley. I can do it. Like, I'll give it a try. So I went in and I actually went back in and had to audition again in a room with casting and our director. And luckily I wasn't as nervous because they knew me. But I auditioned for McKinley and I got it. And I didn't realize how much I wanted to play him until I actually got to play the role. But, you know, if I could do it, if they could give me one more chance, I would really love to take a stab at Elder Cunningham or Elder Price, one of the two leads. I think it would be fun to do either or. They now let, like, Elder Cunningham, if you haven't seen the show, is the bigger guy. He's usually, like, gross looking or nasty, but it's not cast like that anymore, so it can actually be a skinny guy and somebody just quirky, and I would love to give a shot at either one, but you know, I don't know. I think my time with Mormon will just be McKinley for now, but maybe, who knows?
Okay, two more questions. Thomas is dying.
My name is Thomas.
Hi, Thomas.
And my last name is Franklin, and what was your first play? Not professional, just like your first play.
You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. Oh. I was Linus. Oh. Oh, have you guys done that?
Thank you, Thomas. Last question, yes.
Hi, I'm Leah, I'm 13, and I was wondering, like, what other professional plays have you done, maybe, like, on Broadway other than Book of Mormon?
So I've only done one Broadway show, but Broadway's kind of tough to get. It takes a lot of work and a lot of stamina, and it's a business, so you have to get to know people in the business. So I got the Broadway show pretty quick out of when I graduated college, but I also did a Disney cruise ship for a whole year. And so I worked on that and fairly quickly out of college as well. And that was probably my first real, like, really professional gig in terms of this is what I did full time. And then some other shows I did a lot of summer stock, which is regional theater, but I worked at some really big regional theaters, but those shows only last 2 weeks at a time. So you're doing a show and then you stop, then you rehearse for the next show while you're doing the show at night. So you're constantly doing. So I guess the big one out of college after I graduated school was a Disney cruise ship, and I played Hercules. And then, and I did a couple princes. Like a lot, they do a lot of varieties of shows if you've been on that, but, and then I left the ship and I auditioned for Mormon and I got it pretty quickly. So that's kind of like the only Broadway show I've done, but hopefully more will come. Yeah, thank you.
So that was our last question because you guys want to take pictures, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, get some autographs?